Charles Ambrose Bickford was an American actor best known for his strong supporting roles. He was nominated 3 times for the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor, for The Song of Bernadette, The Farmer's Daughter, and Johnny Belinda. Other notable roles include Whirlpool, A Star Is Born and The Big Country. Biography. Early life. Bickford was born in Cambridge, Massachusetts, during the first minute of 1891. The 5th of 7 children, Charles was an intelligent but very independent and unruly child. He had a particularly strong relationship with his maternal grandfather, who was a powerful influence during his formative years. Always more interested in experiencing life than reading about it, Charles was generally considered the wild rogue of this family, causing his parents frequent consternation. In his late teens, he drifted aimlessly around the United States for a time. Before breaking into acting, he worked as a lumberjack, investment promoter, and for a short time, ran a pest extermination business. He was a stoker and fireman in the United States Navy when a friend dared him to get a job in burlesque. His first entry into acting was on the stage, eventually including Broadway. This venue provided him with an occasional living and served as the principal training ground for developing his acting and vocal talents. Acting career. Bickford had intended to attend the Massachusetts Institute of Technology to earn an engineering degree, but while wandering around the country, he became friends with the manager of a burlesque show, who convinced Bickford to take a role in the show. He debuted in Oakland, California in 1911. Bickford enjoyed himself so much that he abandoned his plans to attend MIT. He made his legitimate stage debut with the John Craig Stock Company at the Castle Square Theatre in Boston in 1912. He eventually joined a road company and traveled throughout the United States for more than a decade, appearing in various productions. In 1925, while working in a Broadway play called Outside Looking In, he and co-star James Cagney received rave reviews. He was offered a role in Herbert Brennan's 1926 film of Beau Gesta, but anxious not to give up his newfound Broadway stardom, turned it down, a decision he later came to regret. Following his appearance in the critically praised but unsuccessful Maxwell Anderson Harold Hickerson drama about the Secco and Vanzetti case, Gods of the Lightning, Bickford was contacted by filmmaker Cecil B. DeMille and offered a contract with MGM Studios to star in DeMille's first talking picture, Dynamite. He soon began working with MGM head Louis B. Mayer on a number of projects. He soon became a star after playing Greta Garbo's lover in Anna Christie, but never developed into a leading man. Always of independent mind, exceptionally strong-willed and quick with his fists, Bickford would frequently argue and nearly come to blows with Mayer and any number of other MGM authority figures during the course of this contract with the studio. During the production of DeMille's Dynamite, he punched out his director following a string of heated arguments primarily, but not exclusively, related to the interpretation of his character's role. Throughout his early career on both the stage and later films, Bickford rejected numerous scripts and made no secret of his disdain for much of the material he was offered. Not surprisingly, his association with MGM was short-lived, with Bickford asking for and quickly receiving a release from his contract. However, he soon found himself blacklisted at other studios, forcing him to take the highly unusual step of becoming an independent actor for several years. His career took another turn when in 1935 he was mauled by a lion and nearly killed while filming East of Java. While he recovered, he lost his contract with Fox as well as his leading man status due to extensive neck scarring suffered in the attack, coupled with his advancing age. It was not long, however, before he made a very successful transition to character roles which he felt offered much greater diversity and allowed him to showcase his talent to better effect. Much preferring the character roles that now became his forte, Bickford appeared in many notable films including The Farmer's Daughter, Johnny Belinda, A Star Is Born, and Not as a Stranger. finding great success playing an array of character roles in films and later in television. Bigfoot quickly became highly sought after. His burly frame and craggy, intense features, coupled with a gruff, powerful voice, lent themselves to a wide variety of roles. Most often he played lovable father figures, stern businessmen, heavies, ship captains, or authority figures of some sort. During the 1940s, he was nominated 3 times for the Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor. He served as host of the 1950s television series The Man Behind the Badge. On April 16, 1958, Bigfoot appeared with Roger Smith in The Daniel Barrister Story on NBC's Wagon Train. Meanwhile, Dr. Peter H. Culver, played by Smith, has successfully fought a smallpox epidemic in a nearby town. He is brought to the Wagon Train by Scout Flint McCulloch, portrayed by series regular Robert Horton, to treat Mrs. Barrister. Viewers never knew if Barrister yielded to allow Drive Culver to treat Jenny. Bigfoot continued to act in generally prestigious projects right up to his death. He guest starred on ABC's The Islanders and on NBC's The Barbara Stanwyck Show and The 11th Hour. In his final years, Bigfoot played rancher John Granger, owner of the Shiloh Ranch, on NBC's The Virginian Western series. Two of the actor's most memorable big screen roles came in the Western The Big Country, as a wealthy and ruthless rancher, and in the drama Days of Wine and Roses, as the forlorn father of an alcoholic. In 1965, Bigfoot published his autobiography, Bulls, Balls, Bicycles and Actors. Death. He died in Los Angeles of a blood infection at the age of 76, on November 9, 1967, just days after filming an episode of The Virginian. His death triggered Jennifer Jones' suicide attempt in November 1967. He had a son, Rex, and a daughter, Doris. Partial filmography. Dynamite. Hell's Heroes. Passion Flower. Anna Christie. The Sea Bat. East of Borneo, Men and Her Life, The Squaw Man, The Pagan Lady, Scandal for Sale, No Other Woman, This Day and Age, White Woman, Little Miss Marker, A Wicked Woman, The Farmer Takes a Wife, East of Java, The Plainsman, Pride of the Marines, High, Wide, and Handsome, Daughter of Shanghai, Gangs of New York, Stand Up and Fight, Of Mice and Men, Queen of the Yukon, Reap the Wild Wind, Tarzan's New York Adventure, Mr. Lucky, The Song of Bernadette, Wing and a Prayer, Captain Eddie, Fallen Angel, Jewel in the Sun, The Farmer's Daughter, The Woman on the Beach, Brute Force, The Babe Ruth Story, Four Faces West, Command Decision, Johnny Belinda, Whirlpool, Rosanna McCoy, Riding High, Branded, Guilty of Treason, Jim Thorpe, All American, The Raging Tide, A Star is Born with Judy Garland and James Mason, The Court Martial of Billy Mitchell, Prince of Players, Not as a Stranger, The Dark Wave, You Can't Run Away from It, Mr. Corey, The Big Country, The Unforgiven, Days of Wine and Roses, A Big Hand for the Little Lady,